Hi everyone, my name is Yori Narpati and I am a freelance concept artist and illustrator from Indonesia. And today I'll be showing you some of my favorite tips and tricks that I use to do these kinds of illustrations in Adobe Photoshop. So I've actually used Photoshop for the past 10 years now. It was the first program that I picked up when I first started learning, and it's still the main program that I use today to do most of my work. I find that the user interface is very easy to understand and very easy to pick up if you've never used any Adobe products before. Another added benefit to using Adobe Photoshop is that it integrates well with other CC products such as After Effects to do compositing and Premiere Pro to do video editing. So without further ado, I'm going to show you my favorite basic tips to create these illustrations more efficiently in Adobe Photoshop. Here we go! Okay, so the first tip that I want to show you is how to do perspective guidelines in Photoshop. It's a really simple tool, but it's really helpful when you're trying to do perspective drawings in Photoshop. So you go to your toolbar and you select the polygon tool, this one. You go up here and make sure that the properties is on shape. Change it to no fill and stroke by 1 point. And then you go to these path options and make sure to select star and indent sides by 99%. That's really important. Also go to sides and go 100. And when you're done doing that, you can do a new layer and just click and drag. As you can see, it's made it a lot easier for me to draw in perspective in this drawing. And you can also apply this to 2-point perspective and 3-point perspective as well. You can always just, of course, you can just freehand a line and it'll be somewhat straight, but it won't be perfect every time. So what I do is that I just press shift and I just draw a line in whatever direction I want, and it'll just automatically create a perfect straight line. Another way you can do that is by clicking in one spot, pressing shift, and then clicking in another spot. And they will just, it'll just automatically create a perfect line like so, and you can just fill that shape up. Another way to block out colors in Adobe Photoshop is to use the lasso tool. In this case, I'm using the polygonal lasso tool, and as you can see in the time-lapse video, it's made it a lot easier for me to just block out huge blocks of colors in my image. If I want to do a quick shading on this image, after I pick out my color and pick out a brush size, I can just quickly do a very big stroke and it'll keep it within that shape. So what you want to do is make sure that this symbol right here in the layers tab is clicked. Another one that I want to show you is how to do clipping mask. So I've done a bunch of highlights in this image, but they're all bleeding out of the shape. Now what I can do is I can just click, press Alt on my keyboard and then hover it in between this layer and this folder that I want to clip it to. And once I do that, and you can also stack them. And once I do that, it'll keep it within the shape. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to select my lasso tool and create a very simple leaf shape. And once I'm done with that, I'm going to fill it up with a black. It's very important to do black. Select the shape and go to edit and define brush preset. You can rename it if you like. Once I'm done doing that, I go to my brush settings and do to brush tip shape and increase the spacing, check scattering, shape dynamics, and make sure you change the control to pen pressure. You can just adjust these as you go and see what kind of effect that you like. This all depends on what kind of image you're trying to do. In this case, I'm trying to make a foliage, like a scattering foliage, so that's what I'm trying to do here. I'm just testing it as I go and adjusting the settings until I like how it looks, flipping the X and Y, jitter, and adding in color dynamics, because that also helps. And once I'm happy with the results, I can just add it into my image. So for example, I want to blur this background image right here. I'm just gonna duplicate, and what I like to do is I always like to have a copy of the layers, but here's the merge version of that image, of that layer, and then I go to filter and then blur, and then some of the blur that I like to use is Gaussian blur and motion blur. I'm gonna use motion blur for this one. Can adjust the angle, and I usually just use just a little bit just to suggest some depth in the image. And once I'm happy with that, I'm just gonna okay it. And then another thing that I like to do is I like to add in noise, just adding a little bit of texture. I can just create a new layer and fill it in with just a gray color. And then I go to filter and then noise and then add noise. You can check or uncheck this box depending on what you want, but I want it to be monochromatic, so I'm going to check that box. And you can change the amount of noise that you want. You want it to be very subtle, so I usually just go for about this much. And once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to okay it. And you can change the layer blending style here and just look for the one that looks best with your current image. So with this particular image, I think it looks best with divide. So I'm just going to select that and go to my erase tool and just erase parts that I don't want. So that's the end of the video. I hope that was somewhat helpful for some of you, and I hope you try these in your own projects at home. And thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.